Ah, the orgasm. We tend to talk about the orgasm as this magical moment of pure bliss that's the culmination of our sexual activity. Yet, like many of my exes, we actually know very little about orgasms. Especially when it comes to how orgasms differ at the intersections of gender and sexual orientations. Recognizing the lack of research in this area, Karen Blair, Jacqueline Cappell, and Caroline Pukall recently conducted a study exploring which sexual activities result in frequent or satisfying orgasms between men and women across different sexualities. Before we get into that, we do actually know a bit about the differences in orgasms between cisgendered men and women. Women typically report orgasms in about 40 to 65% of sexual activity. Men, however, report 85 to 95%. Dang, that's a big difference. One possible reason for this is heteronormative scripts. No, that's not an unsubtly named Michael Bay movie, but instead the cultural ideas of what is normal when it comes to sex and sexuality. And these heteronormative scripts tend to favor activities that lead to male orgasms over female orgasms, like penis and vagina intercourse. Men are given far more agency than women in sexual activity. And speaking of heteronormativity, where are the queers? When researching human sexuality, we rarely discuss same-sex relationships. We also just talk as if every orgasm was created the same, and never discuss how satisfaction may differ. Haven't we all had some pretty unsatisfying orgasms? I mean, I have. This study attempts to examine orgasm frequency and satisfaction across same-sex and mixed-sex relationships between men and women in 14 different sexual activities. 14 activities? I didn't even know there were that many. I had like two. So what would we find out? Are men more satisfied than women by orgasms? Are men in mixed-sex relationships having more orgasms than those in same-sex relationships? Do queer and straight women have the same satisfaction with their orgasms? Or is every lesbian right when they say they know how to treat a lady better in the bedroom? To conduct this survey, 806 individuals between the ages of 18 and 79 who are in relationships completed an online questionnaire. Of those 806, 61.4% were women, and 1.1% identified as transgender, like myself. And most lived in the United States and Canada, as well as a few other Western nations like the United Kingdom, Australia, etc. 47.9% identified as gay or lesbian, 44.3% as straight, 5.4% as bisexual, and 2.5% defining themselves as undefined. You go, 2.5%. You go. Just over half of the relationships on the survey were considered same-sex, with the rest as mixed-sex relationships. Finally, us queers get to be the slight majority for once. To analyze the data, participants were then put into four groups: women in same-sex relationships, women in mixed-sex relationships, men in same-sex relationships, and men in mixed-sex relationships. In the online survey, participants were asked questions about different sexual activities, such as giving or receiving oral sex, anal sex, hand penis stimulation, or manipulating the clitoris. Ah, clitoral manipulation. Such an unromantic term. So let's talk about some of the more interesting statistics that were discovered. Women in mixed-sex relationships reported more frequent sexual activity without orgasm. Big surprise there. Women in same-sex relationships reported more satisfaction from receiving oral sex than women in mixed-sex relationships. Men and women in same-sex relationships reported receiving oral sex more than those in mixed-sex, because apparently queers like to go down more. Men in mixed-sex relationships also desire to receive more oral sex. Women in mixed-sex relationships reported less satisfaction while giving oral sex. Men in mixed-sex and women in same-sex relationships also wanted to give more oral sex, because apparently everyone wants to go down on women more. Men in both types of relationships had greater satisfaction from orgasms derived from penetrative intercourse than women did. Women in same-sex relationships reported having the most frequent amount of sexual encounters with multiple orgasms. Score one for the lesbians. Men in mixed-sex relationships had the most satisfaction with orgasms from vaginal intercourse alone, and reported having it more frequently than women in either relationship type. Women in same-sex relationships had the greatest satisfaction and frequency of orgasms with clitoral manipulation with a partner, but women in both mixed-sex and same-sex relationships reported having the same amount of frequency and satisfaction from orgasms when manipulating the clit by themselves. Manipulating the clit. We have got to find a more elegant way to say that. Women in same-sex relationships have the greatest satisfaction and frequency of orgasm from oral sex. Men in same-sex relationships had more satisfaction with anal sex orgasms and had them more frequently than in mixed-sex relationships. perhaps we didn't require a study to discover that one. But hey, we're doing science here. Where can we go with all this information? The results provide further evidence that suggests that the difference in orgasm rates between men and women are more likely caused by differences in preferred or practiced sexual behaviors, rather than any biological or physiological difference in sexes. Basically meaning, the reason men and women have different amounts of orgasms isn't because men and women are so different, but perhaps because of the different types of sex that different couple types have. For example, women reported no difference in the frequency of orgasms when they masturbated, regardless of their sexual orientation. But the number of orgasms differed greatly depending on if they were with a man or with a woman's sexual partner. A fact which we learn by comparing women in same and mixed sex relationships. So it isn't that women's ability to get off is in question, but rather the ability of their partner to get them off. Also, women in same-sex relationships reported high frequency and satisfaction of orgasms, but women in mixed-sex relationships didn't report the same. Score 2 for the lesbians. Women in same-sex relationships reported more satisfying and frequent orgasms from clitoral manipulation, there's our old friend, and oral sex, which may suggest that women in same-sex relationships may be more in tune with and adept at manipulating other women's bodies. Score 3 for the lesbians. And I think this means they take home the gold? Yes? A lot of these differences may come down to those heterosexual scripts that we talked about before. In heterosexual relationships, the male orgasm tends to be the end of sex, which reduces the chance for their female partners to have as many and more satisfying orgasms as women in same-sex relationships, considering that there's no male orgasms to be had. Another interesting thing to note is that while men in mixed-sex relationships reported wanting to perform oral sex on their female partners more often, their female partners reported that they didn't want to receive oral sex more. While there are a variety of possible reasons to explain that, such as female partners not enjoying oral sex, though that doesn't match with women in same-sex relationships, it could also be possible that women simply didn't wish to reciprocate oral sex on men. Considering that women in mixed-sex relationships reported giving oral sex as not very satisfying, it's certainly a possibility. In the end, women in mixed-sex relationships reported the most frequent sexual activity that didn't end in any orgasm at all. But like we discussed before, this is unlikely due to an inability to reach orgasm, and more likely to be a function of not engaging in the right kinds of activities that are more likely to get women off. The findings of this study show that sexual behavior and orgasm experiences do differ based on one's gender and the gender of one's partner. And as lesbians knew the whole time, women in same-sex relationships may have much to teach those in other relationships about having orgasms. So basically, straight dudes, if you want to get your partner off, perhaps it's time you start taking notes from the lesbians. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you want to support this and similar LGBT inclusive research, please consider checking out some other videos and studies by KLB Research, as well as supporting them over on Patreon. Every dollar helps. So even if you only want to give $1 a month, please consider becoming a KLB patron.